Hello, beloved. I welcome you back to the Way of Salvation program. I believe you are loving the program and it's opening your eyes concerning demonic activities in this world. Today, I want us to still continue on the subject demons and deception. That is what I was talking about the other time. That because demons are deceiving people, they have set up churches and put their men in charge to teach distorted things, to deceive the ignorant. And that was what I was trying to let you understand. And some of the teachings I said the other time was that they criticized Jesus. First, they deny the story of Jesus. They speak against him. And my point was that you cannot say you are building a church and speak against the founder. If I, as the founder of Action Power of Faith Ministries, set up another church in a country, the resident pastor can never say he dislikes me. He cannot say he doesn't like me. He cannot say if I, as the founder, I don't exist. Imagine if that can be possible. Because I established the branch, and I put him there. So there's no way he can speak against me. That is what I'm talking about. So let's continue to hear some few points to let them see that we are not ignorant of their deceptive ways, but our eyes are open as children of God with the Holy Spirit inside us. So I continue to let us understand that some of the teachings about the false prophets, you don't have to listen to them, especially if they attack the personality of Jesus. Every church you go to, that the prophet or the pastor or the preacher, suit or whatever name you may give to him, begins to talk against Jesus, please know that this place is demonic. Know that the place you've been to is a demonic place, because is only using the church as a cover-up. So let's hear some of the scriptures that will let you understand that these things are cover-ups. The first scripture that I want us to look at is 2 Peter, when Peter was warning the church. Interestingly, in the days of the apostles, some of these demonic teachings also sprang up. They were trying to deceive people by attacking the personality of Jesus. And the apostles took their time to explain these things to the believers there. Peter said, but there were also false prophets among the people. You see, always that is the way of the demons to set up churches. Put false prophets, as the Lord prophesied, to deceive people. There will be false prophets. There were also false prophets among the people, even as there will be false teachers among you. We also have false teachers. And he said, who will secretly bring in destructive heresies, even denying the Lord who bought them and brought on themselves swift destruction and brought on themselves swift destruction. Verse 2 says, and many will follow their destructive ways, because of whom the way of the truth will be blasphemed. What Peter was saying here is that the false prophets denied the Lord Jesus who bought them. They deny. I want to emphasize on the word deny. You see, they deny the law. You cannot say Jesus is not the law whilst you tell other people or you have written in front of the building church. That is the deception I'm talking about. That is what demons are doing. They use church as a cover-up. They use church to deceive the ignorant. But I want your eyes to open so that you will not fall victims to these things. They think they are smart, but you see, it's childish. These things beat only the baby. You see? So Peter was telling them that they should be careful. False prophets deny Jesus. So any person who denies Jesus is fake, is a demonic person. Then he says, those people are destroying people. He said, many will follow their destructive ways. Their teachings are destroying people. It doesn't build people. Because of them, some people are fed up. And they say they don't want to go to church. It is because of false teachings and false prophets. So please, don't be disturbed, please. If you are seeking to be in heaven, don't be disturbed. Don't be disturbed at all. God's people are around. We have true men of God who are teaching the correct things. So don't be disturbed at all. So the first thing I want you to understand is that they deny the Lord Jesus. Okay. Then let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 3. He said, therefore, I make known to you that no one speaking by the Spirit of God calls Jesus accursed. And no one can say that Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. You see, I, as the servant who consider Jesus as the Lord, I say that because I have the Holy Spirit. And they, as false teachers and false prophets, deny him and curse Jesus because they don't have the Holy Spirit. Simple. And if you don't have the Holy Spirit, why do you have in you then? Demons. That's what I'm talking about. So all the so-called preachers who say they are pastors, who are duping innocent people in the name of church, but denying and insulting Jesus, have demons inside them. Why? Demons are enemies of the cross. Demons are enemies of heaven. So they don't like Jesus. That is why they put human beings there to say things that will discredit the Holy God, the Holy Man. You see? So that is the next thing I want to point out. If you say you hold Bible, you cannot not speak against Jesus. That is why I said the other time that people of other religions don't speak against the religious leaders. Why then you, who calls yourself a Christian, and you insult Jesus? That shows that you are fake. Now let's go to Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 5, verse 6. The book of Mark chapter 5, verse 6. When the Lord Jesus crossed over to the land of the Gadarenes, there was a madman who was in the cemetery. And the Bible said he was chained, and people could not set him free because he was very wild, and nobody there came near him. And when he saw Jesus in Mark chapter 5, let's hear what happened. Verse 6 says, when he saw Jesus from afar, he ran and worshipped him. You see, my point here is that even the demons deceiving you, the human being, it is big deception. They are at the back door. They know that Jesus is the Lord. They know. So you are the human being being deceived. You as a human being are being deceived. The demons themselves know that Jesus is the most powerful. They know that Jesus is their Lord. He has power over them. That's what I mean. He has power over them. So the man, the demons in the man. Don't forget that if it was the man himself, then people could have gone there to the cemetery and set him free. The fact that they couldn't get near him, and the Lord asked him, what is your name? He said, my name is Legion. A lot of demons lived in that man. So if it was the man himself, he wouldn't do what he did. Because he may not know Jesus. But the demons in him knew Jesus. So they ran and worshipped him. And when they worshipped him, let's hear what they said. And he cried out with a loud voice, talking about the man with demons, and said, "What have I to do with you, Jesus, the Son of the Most High God?" Hallelujah. It means demons know that Jesus is the Most High God. Jesus is the Son of the Most High God. Talking about the human Jesus. He is the Son of the Most High God. You see, demons even know that. So he said, "I implore you by God that you do not torment me." So three things the demons did here. Number one, they bowed before him. So even the demons can bow. So you as a human being talking, you are being fooled to the highest level. How can somebody worship Jesus at the back door and whisper through your ears, "Don't believe him, don't believe him"? It's deception. So they worship Jesus, whatever they say. They bow before him. Number two, they know that he is the Son of the Most High God as a human being. Number three, they know that Jesus can torment them. He can terrorize them in the spirit. He can not let them feel uncomfortable. That is what it means. So you have to understand that if anyone calls himself a pastor and have issues with Jesus, that is the deception I'm talking about. So I want to open your eyes. Then let's go to Matthew chapter 8, verse 29. The demons in the man cried out, saying, "What have we to do with you?" They know that they are on one side and Jesus and his people are on the other side. So they also said, "Son of God." They also called Jesus Son of God. So you can see that even the true identity of Jesus can be seen by the confession of demons themselves. The demons are the one who introduced Jesus to the people in the Bible. You see? So they said, "Have you come to torment us before the time?" That is my point. Before the time. What is that time? There's a time coming when Jesus will judge the living and the dead, bind all demons, and bring them to eternal hell. You see? So there's no way somebody can hold Bible and speak blasphemously against Jesus and say he's a man of God. You have lost your mind. You have lost your mind. You insult the founder of the church and you are telling people. It is only the ignorant, the unlearned, people who don't know what they are about, disoriented people who sit under such men of God. Because they are not even men of God. They are false teachers, demonic people. That's what I want us to understand. You see, anybody who criticizes Jesus has demons. I'm talking about you calling yourself a Christian. If some people don't believe in Jesus, if they are not Christians, they can have their opinion. I don't have a problem about that because they are entitled to their opinions. That is why many people believe in different religions. But my problem is that if you call yourself a Christian and what you are doing is say it's church, that is serious. It is worse than those who are outside. If those who are outside the church criticize the Lord, they don't know what they are talking about. They have different faith. But you, as a Christian, if you do that, you have betrayed yourself. You see. Peter was still talking. And let's hear what Peter says. 2 Peter chapter 2. "By covetousness, they will exploit you with deceptive words." You see, they just want some things from you. So they deceive you with those words. You see? Then he says, "For a long time, their judgment has not been idle, and their destruction does not slumber." He says, they are covetous people who are using deceptive words, you see, to mislead the innocent. So I'm just adding more scriptures to the point that if anyone speaks against Jesus, that person should not be accepted as his servant. That is simple. That makes him a deceptive person. That makes him a demonic person. Yeah, when I said the deception is big, because even the demons in you acknowledge that he is the Lord. So how come you as a human being, you speak against the one who founded the church? You see, let us understand that these are the small things demons are doing to deceive people. Your eyes should be open, so that from today going, any man talking, wherever you go, and they have written the word church, find out if he is not. And there's one other aspect of it. If they have demons inside them, there's no way they can speak good about Jesus. If they try, still, you can see faults with what they say. So may God help you today for you to understand that demons have set up these churches and they are teaching distorted things to deceive the ignorant. That is why I want to open your eyes so that you will not fall victims. You will not fall a victim to the demons. Let your eyes open, and wherever you go and you hear people talking, maligning, and vilifying Jesus, then you can know that this is one of the demonic places I've come. Run away from demons. I love you. I don't want you to go to hell with the demons. But God sent me here to alert you so that your eyes will open and live holy for him and enter the kingdom of God. God bless you. I'll see you again next time. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for watching this video. I really hope you have been enlightened. To hear more, you may subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to see more videos. Pastor Kukudatsi has written a very informative book called How Demons Operate. Grab yourself a copy to know how they operate and know how to liberate yourself from demonic oppression. To stay in contact with us, you can reach us through these details. God bless you.